those of you that have watched it on the internet, here it is. It's time to paint today. So the airplane's prepped. As you know, you guys have watched it all along. It's a deception. Cheated down from 1/4 inch to 3/16 on the fuselage side. Glassed in 06 cloth with the Wings West MGS epoxy. I've primered it. 2 coats of catalyzed primer, and I'm prepped out now 320 wet. So at this point, it's time to start spraying. Okay, so prep solvents are pretty much gone. I don't know where the rest of you are, but obviously we're in California. So this paint job is going to be nitrocellulose lacquer, urethane colors, and then urethane clear coat. Back in the 80s, we had Prepsol, other thinners, some guys use acetone. The closest thing I've come to it is alcohol. So I start with rubbing alcohol and wipe it off. And the easiest way there is just wet it down. And what you're trying to do now is cure any of that water that would be hanging out. Any of those overspray places that after you wet sand that you missed. And obviously at the end of this, we're left, I know, with the lint from the paper towel. Now we have online, we sell a spray can version of this primer, but it's not catalyzed. This one is sprayed in the 2-stage primer, catalyzed polyester based primer. And the cool thing is I don't know what we were doing in the 80s, spraying the airplanes gray, but now with white primers, you cut, since most everybody sprays base white, you've cut the amount of paint necessary to begin with by half. I'm gonna spray this a little different. I'm gonna spray this off a scuba tank, which is different than everybody complains about a big compressor. For most of the graphics and the small stuff, the $79 Harbor Freight, you know, small Sears compressor will work. I'm gonna shoot it off a scuba tank, and there's a couple of advantages. Everybody starts talking about water traps, and they start talking about filters. I agree there can be some oil and there can be some contaminants that come from the compressor, but 90% of the water comes from the temperature. It doesn't come from the compressor. It's because you have hot air against a cold space. Today's 75 degrees, zero humidity, as obviously Southern California. So by spraying off the scuba tank, I get 2 benefits. One, you guys don't hear the compressor turn on during the filming, but also I'm guaranteed even temperature, and that's what's key. The aluminum 80 scuba tank will spray an entire airplane, primer, base, clear, everything. So today that's the base. The gun is the world famous $25 Harbor Freight gun. So I'm showing you that there's no smoke and mirrors with big money. It's just a basic car detail gun. We're spraying it at the top end of an HVL pressure. So we're spraying high, we're spraying in the 25 to 30 PSI range. This gun shoots about a 4 to 6 inch pattern. And I've already pre-mixed the paint. I've taken the paint, cut the paint 50%. The paint should be going on loose. It should be going on very, very thin. That's the goal, obviously. And with the white primer, with the paint slightly thinner than normal, I then can control how much paint I'm putting on. The paint should go on loose. It should go on really, really thin, obviously, for weight savings. But at the same time, if you mix your paint slightly thinner than slightly heavier, a little more viscous than what the factory recommends, you can control the amount of paint you're putting on. Now, they'll tell you to mix it per factory recommendation, and if you're painting the fender of your Toyota Camry, fantastic. But in a pattern airplane, obviously, we're trying to keep the weight down as much as possible. So by going slightly more viscous or slightly more thin than regular, I then, in areas where I have breakthrough or I need an extra pass, I can then control how much I'm putting on. And the paint we're going on today is very similar to automotive base coats, but it's the real deal. This airplane's going nitrocellulose lacquer, which is pretty much gone from most areas of the country. We sell some of it. It's available in more areas than others, but honestly, it's by far the easiest and fastest way. If you do it with a base coat product similar to what we sell, the monocoat paints or any of the solvent-based paints, easy to work with, easy to clear, easy to graphic. But when you start getting into artwork, 2, 3, and 4 colors, you'll find that the base coat smudges, smears, and collects stains. In a lacquer situation, you can nib that off with a little 600 and keep on going. In a base coat, it's been my experience that it's hard to control the contamination. So this airplane's going nitrocellulose lacquer. I wish you guys, everybody could stand here and see it done. So we're just putting it on. They call it a tack coat. It's probably a little more than that. It's probably more because I don't want it to sit and turn to gravel. I don't want it to sit and turn into orange peel. So I'm conscious of the fact of how much I'm putting on, but at the same time, I'm looking for it to flow. I'm looking for it to create some kind of a coverage. Black or white, man, 1985 in the house. We'll dedicate this one to Mr. Craig Millett, the man that showed us how to pull the gun back in the day. So what's interesting is, it's painted really, really easy. The coverage is phenomenal. It went on with the white primer, it almost took no paint. The entire fuselage is under an eighth of a pint reduced. So I'm interested to see what happens when I put it back down and put the scale back on it. Now, the other thing I didn't mention before is, it's 75 and it's lacquer, and I went slow on the thinner. It's really important that you guys slow down your thinner and not get in a rush that has to be done tonight. Because it's important that the paint stay wet at the beginning. So as you get all the way around to the finish, that the place that you started from is still wet, so the paint cross-links and homogenizes together. And you'll find that the slower thinner you do, if you can take a patience pill before you pick up the gun, you'll end up in a better spot. You'll end up putting less paint down because it gives you more time to adjust and look for those light areas. There's a lot of bobbing and weaving. And the big thing that we have today is fantastic lighting. I can't mention it enough. You don't want the lights on your ceiling. In my garage, we actually have two on the wall. So I'm looking at you guys and looking off the top of the airplane into the light. And that's critical. And you see me, you know, doing the bob and weave, looking for that orange peel, looking for that rough area. So at this point, it'll dry overnight, it'll stay on the sand, and then I'll nib it off. I see a couple pieces of dust, I get out of it without any runs, and then I'll tape it off. And from there, you guys know what you're doing. It's fine line, we're gonna go computer graphics, graphic it out, some pearl paints, back and forth, and then we'll end up in the clear. I'll try and shoot another video for you guys when we go to the clear, because that's gonna get really magical. And we're pushing hard to have it at the AMA show in 15. But other than that, it's base white, and it's light. So hang on, see you soon.